Hello and welcome back to fattybull.com. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up the latest and greatest Unreal 4 editor with the DX12 and the RTX technology from Nvidia. So we are going to show, number one, how to check your Windows system, operating system, how to check the DX12 and how to make sure what specific Nvidia drivers you have to install, plus of course how to launch and execute then the Unreal 4 editor to make sure and double and triple check that retracing is turned on, what you have to do in the project settings and so on. And at the end, you also feel free to download a free demo scene file you can find on my website fattybull.com. So everything is provided for you to double and triple check that the Unreal Studio is running perfectly with the DX12 setup. So let's get started. Step number one, checking your Windows system. Why do you want to check your Windows system? First of all, you check it by clicking on the search box here and type in WinVer for Windows version, and you want to check what Windows operating system and build you have installed, because the RTX and DX12 ray tracing only works with operating system build 17763.348 and above and higher. As you can see, I have installed 557, so it's actually pretty good to know that you need to check this first. Okay, so now let's say you figure out, okay, Windows 10, I'm not up to date. How can I make sure that I can get my latest Windows update? So you go back to your Windows search box and you type in Windows update. And when you click it, you find here the possibility to check for updates. You click the button. Of course, you have to be online. Make sure you have a good internet connection. And then you should automatically update. It will take a little bit to download, of course, the installer, depending on what version you have. And then you have to reboot and restart your machine. Once this is done, so this is Windows updating, right? Then I got the question, Bernhard, how can I make sure that my system has also the DX12 running and everything went fine? So you type into the Windows search box again, DXDIHG, and when you run that command, the so-called DirectX diagnostic tool is popping up, and then you can see what specific DirectX version you have been or you have installed on your computer, right? So as you can see, in my particular case, it's DirectX 12. So this is exactly what you want to have. If you see, for instance, DirectX 9, 10, 11, then I got the question, can I just download this extra, you know, patch, so to speak? But there are, from my understanding, what I have been finding out, there is no such thing that you can just download and install a DirectX patch. What you have to do is you have to update the latest Windows system, and then DirectX 12 is automatically included. Okay, so this is where you can check that the update should have been running correct and that you're on DX12. So the next check that is very important is, of course, in the display settings, you can see what specific Nvidia card or graphics card you have installed at all. Keep in mind, Nvidia is supporting the retracing in the Unreal Engine with the RTX system. So that means it is required that you also have an RTX card installed, and then you have for sure the full features of the RTX in the Unreal Engine supported. Okay, so you see this here. Next step, of course, and this is even more important, is to install the latest drivers. For this particular reason, you go to the Nvidia GeForce website, and it's geforce.com drivers. You see it here then in the tabs. You click on drivers, and if you do so, you have to make sure that you really select what you need. Okay, so I learned that I had to install manual drivers for this particular case, and I'll show you now exactly why, and I guide you through. If you do not install the correct drivers, it will not work. The Unreal Engine or the retracing will not work. It might even crash. So the first thing, of course, it's a GeForce. In my particular case, you want to select that. And then you also see here, and I want to make sure that you pay enough attention to this because it happened to me. I picked the wrong ones all the time. I did it two times actually wrong. Very, very smart, I have to say. I learned it the hard way. But it was my own fault, so because I didn't pay attention. As you can see, I was looking into GeForce, and then I didn't pay attention, and there is, in the brackets, it says clearly notebooks, right? And I didn't check that, and I had to make sure, and if you're on the desktop version as well, make sure it's an RTX 20 series, and it's for the desktop version, right, and not a notebook. Then also, GeForce, it depends on now, be very specific what RTX cards you have. Is it a Ti, a 2080, or 2080 Ti, or 2070, and so on, and just make sure you select the right one. Of course, the operating system is, in my particular case, a Windows 10 64-bit. English is my language. And then attention, please. This is extremely important here. So the next two factors are very, very important. Is it a standard driver you have to install or a DCH? Keep in mind, if you pick the wrong one, it doesn't work. So how can you figure out what specific driver package you need for the Unreal Studio version to make sure that the RTX retracing is working? So to figure out if you need a standard or a DCH, you have to do the following, okay? You go to your computer, to the desktop, right mouse click, and then you press and select Nvidia control panel. Once this is done, you go to the very bottom here of your Nvidia control panel and click system information. And then here you can read what actually is required for your system. In my particular case, you can see it's a GeForce RTX 2080 and the driver type is standard. Okay, so if it's standard, this is now a no-brainer. Now I know exactly what I need. I go back and I select standard. But it could be that your system requires DCH package, okay? So whatever it requires, whatever you see in the NVIDIA control panel, this is what you would like to select. Then the next thing is it basically the recommended or certified version, a beta version, a studio driver. You want to make sure if you are going to use the Unreal Studio version, you download the studio driver. So the next thing is you click start search, and of course it is going to tell you there are your correct drivers and the correct driver package. It's the NVIDIA Studio driver. In this particular case, it's 430.86. Okay, and the latest release was May 27th. And by the way, we have already July. But anyways, this is how you do it. Then you install it, and you make sure after you install this package, you reboot your system, and we're going to the next step, and this is to the so-called Unreal Studio version. So where to download the latest version, how to get it? It's of course from Epic Games, and the domain is unrealengine.com. As you can see here, I'm using the US version /studio. You see it here in the URL of my web browser, and currently the latest version is 4.22. So you scroll down to the bottom of this page and then you make sure get the free beta version now. So you click on it and then you say download Unreal Studio, and this is going to give you the installer for the Epic Launcher. So once the Epic Launcher is set up and ready, you launch it, and I'll show you how this one looks like. And if you do that, you can clearly see here Epic Games, you have the home buttons, etc. And if you click on library, so you scroll down, click on Unreal Engine on the left, then you click on library, and then you see what engines are currently installed. If you would like to install other engines, like previous ones, older ones, 4.2, you just click on this little plus button here, right? And then it is asking you, do you want to install it and do you want to set it as the current? As you can see, I have two engines installed. I had the previous one, 4.21.2, and now I have 4.22.3 installed. Okay, so this is very, very important. Downloading those packages, as you can see, they're pretty big. Total size is like 45 gigs, so give it some time. Get a coffee or whatever, and until it's installed, you can actually launch the engine. But there is even more to do in order to run it with the DX12 and to make sure that the ray tracing works. Even so, after you have been updating the Windows system, after you have been checking the DX12, and after you have been installing the latest Nvidia drivers for your RTX cards, right? If you are launching the Unreal Engine through the Epic Launcher as it is right now here, and you say launch the engine, you will see that the ray tracing is still not working. And the reason why is because you need to make sure that the engine definitely runs in the DX12. This is very, very important in the DX with the DX12 technology. So how can you check that? So I'm currently just loading a demo scene file here from this project, and I want to show you live how you can actually check that. So you go, once you load a project, you go up here, and then you can check what graphics is actually running. And as you can see, when you hover over, it shows you it's still running on DirectX 11. And even in your project settings, you have to go here and make sure that ray tracing is turned on, even if ray tracing is turned on, but you run it through the Epic Launcher, the standard Epic Launcher, it's not working. The ray tracing is not working. So how can you fix this? How can you make sure that, you know, the engine is running with the latest DirectX 12 version? So you close it, and then I want to show you where you can find actually the Epic downloader. So on the program files, Epic Games, you see here are the two different engines I have been installing, 2.1 and 2.2. You click on 2.2, then you go to the engine itself, click in binaries, and then you see if it's a Win64, 32, Mac, Linux, whatever system you are on. You click on it, and then you can find the so-called UE4 editor, okay? And this UE4 editor is basically launching it. And what I did here on my desktop, you can see I created a shortcut. So right mouse click and create a shortcut and put it on the desktop. And right mouse click on the shortcut, click on properties. And then you see I was adding at the very end of the shortcut target -DX12. Okay, and this is the key, how to launch the editor in the DX12 mode. So if you launch it through the shortcut here right now and double click it, then you launch the engine without using the Epic Launcher. Instead, you launch the engine directly with the application, and on top of it, you told the engine also to run in the DX12 mode. So far, unfortunately, I haven't seen an update from Epic that it's working through the Epic Launcher. It might be with the next release. That would be cool. But so far, you need to make sure that you run your engine with the DX12. Otherwise, the retracing, it's not working. So, and we are almost there. You almost did it. And now, as you can see, this is a project I was starting, and I hover over. It's called Studio Setup, and it shows you DirectX 12. DirectX 12 is running up and running. And now let's also check the project settings. Let's do this. Let's load them and bring them up. And let's make sure that retracing is also checked and turned on, and it is. You can also find this under, where is it, under rendering, and then you can see here under the rendering also that reflections or whatever and lighting and retracing is turned on, but I basically just go to retracing and make sure everything is set up. So there is one more thing. I was setting up a demo scene file for you with all the correct settings that you don't need to worry, and you can download this demo scene file for free, absolutely for free, on my website, fedibull.com. And when you run this demo, then you should basically see that everything is up and running. It's beautiful. It goes fast. You can see there is a chrome reflective shader, and I put in one chair and the floor material. And you can see that everything runs as it should, right? So if you have any questions and if you feel this video was helpful, then feel free, first of all, ask me your questions below the video. I'm more than happy to respond to you and answer all your questions. Number two, if you like it, please subscribe and of course help me creating more of those videos, and thumbs up if you feel like it was helpful for you. And of course, please visit my website, fedibull.com. You find lots of free project files to download, shaders, materials, PBR materials, whatever you're interested in. And I'm going to publish more and more video tutorials and making of. So I hope this was helpful. Thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you also in on my website, and feel free to contact me either through YouTube, Vimeo, through my website. You can also tweet, send me a tweet, or send me a direct WhatsApp message to my cell phone. Yes, even that is possible. So that being said, I love to hear from you. Thank you so much for watching. All the best. Take care, and good luck also for your projects, and hopefully I hear from you soon. Take care, and happy retracing.